This is a review of the brand new KJV Rainbow Study Bible from Holman. And the Holman Rainbow Study Bible has a unique color coding system that allows readers to quickly and easily identify 12 major themes of Scripture throughout the text: God, discipleship, love, faith, sin, evil, salvation, family, outreach, commandments, history, and prophecy are those 12 themes. We're going to get into the Rainbow Study Bible and look at some of the differences in the previous editions of this and this new and latest edition from Holman, and excited to do this review and very thankful to Holman for this sample copy. And we're going to get right into the features of the new Holman Rainbow Study Bible. This is the Holman Rainbow Study Bible, and we're going to take a look at the box here, the new one from Holman, and specifically we are reviewing what's called the Mantova Brown Leather Touch Edition, and Holman Rainbow Study Bible, Study God's Word in full color. We've got the, of course, on the side there, of course, this is the KJV, which is the only version we sell here at the KJV Store, and on the back of the box, we've got some of the listing of some of the basic features that we went over there, the unique color coding system, and there are those different color coded topics: God, discipleship, love, faith, sin, evil, salvation, family, outreach, commandments, history, and prophecy. And then we get our nice page sample here of the Holman Rainbow Study Bible, and we're going to see the thematic color coding. So every single verse in the Bible appears with a color. It has a background color and is color coded. We're going to see these examples of the maps and illustrations, and there's a color coding key on every page. That's new. We're going to get into that, the bold line system, and the center column cross references, KJV King James Version, and there we go. So getting into this Bible here, once again, the Mantova Brown Leather Touch. It's basically, I would compare it to the quality of probably a bonded leather. It's a really beautiful cover, and certainly has the look and appearance of leather. Still fairly flexible. You do definitely have some nice gold page edges. Those definitely pop. The ribbon marker itself is also brown to match the cover of the Bible. That's a nice feature. And here we've got our brown inside Holman Rainbow Study Bible. And specifically, we're gonna get over here to some of the introductory material. And there's a preface to the reader. I'm not going to hit on that so much. Specifically, I'm going to get to this words of explanation. And I like here where it talks about the title. And the title, it says, "The Holman Rainbow Study Bible may seem an obvious title for a Bible of many colors, but there are several significant reasons for this choice. First, as our scriptural promise from the opening book of the Bible, Genesis 9, 8 through 17, points out, the full color rainbow is a gift from God and the seal of his covenant with mankind. In the closing book of the Bible, Revelation 4, 3, a dazzling color encircles the very throne of God. The Holman Rainbow Study Bible has new study features found in no other Bible. These features include color coding of every verse of the Bible and distinguishing all spoken words of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Study is simplified in the Holman Rainbow Study Bible." But the Rainbow Bible is not something that's new. I mean, the original one came out in the late 80s by a different company. It's been rebranded and republished by different publishers: Rainbow Studies International, Standard Publishing, even Power Publishing, and Everett Gaddy of the Subject Bible fame. But now, basically, it's been redone by Holman, and we're going to kind of go through some of the differences in this newer one. The Rainbow is the first Bible to, and the only Bible to ever completely color code every verse. That still remains true. But what's really neat about this Bible is some of the other additional features that are going to be outlined. And to get kind of right into that, before we get to the example there and some of the actual page examples, I want to go to the color-coded guide for subject headings. Now, on the old Rainbow Study Bible, and you may still even see it on our site, the old one actually came with a bookmark. You got a bookmark in your Rainbow Study Bible, and it had these topics. So, of course, purple for God. We're going to say that that's an orange for discipleship, a green for love. Faith is kind of a lighter brown. Sin is a little bit of a darker gray. Evil is a darker brown. Salvation is blue. Yellow is family. The outreach is pink. Commandments is a lighter green. History is a lighter gray, and prophecy is kind of a gold or a tan tone. You'll have to bear with me with my colors may not be the best at naming some of those colors, but we'll certainly be able to distinguish what those are and what those subject headings are. Now it goes further. Color-coded guide for subject categories. So God, well, now it defines even further. God, okay, well, that's specifically in the purple talking about the Father, the Son, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, discipleship, obedience and praise, love, which is joy and kindness in the green, faith, that's prayer and miracles in the orange there, sin, the dark gray, temptation, judgment of the ungodly, evil, which is the darker brown, Satan, false teachers, idolatry. And we're going to see the salvation there, salvation in the blue, blessings and deliverance, family, genealogies and marriage in the yellow, outreach in the pink, teaching or counseling, commandments in the green, offerings in the law, history in the lighter gray, creation and war, and prophecy in the gold, promises or covenants. And I like how it actually goes and breaks down these subjects even further, but now we actually get to full-blown examples of color-coded verses in the Holman Rainbow Study Bible. Okay, God in purple, we would want an example. Well, here we go. Psalm 95:3 says, "For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods." Here's an example of discipleship. Discipleship, John 12:26. "If any man serve me, let him follow me, and where I am, there shall also my servant be." Love in the green. 1 John 4:7. "Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God." And faith. There's Hebrews 11:1. "Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen." Definitely a great example of faith and the color coding system there. Sin in the gray. James 1:15. "Then when lust hath conceived, it bringeth forth sin, and sin, when it is finished, bringeth forth death." And here's an example of evil. 1 Peter 5:8. "Your adversary the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour." Salvation in the blue. Acts 4:12. "Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved." Amen. And family in the yellow there, Ephesians 5:31. "For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother and shall be joined unto his wife, and they two shall be one flesh." Outreach in the pink, Proverbs 14:25. "A true witness delivereth souls, but a deceitful witness speaketh lies." Green commandments, Exodus 20:8-10. "Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work, but the seventh day," and we know that ends, "thou shalt rest." And that's an excellent example of the commandment. History in the lighter gray, 1 Samuel 17:4. "And there went out a champion out of the camp of the Philistines named Goliath of Gath, whose height was 6 cubits and a span. There in the excellent story of David and Goliath. Excellent history example. And prophecy, 2 Peter 1:21, "For the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man, but holy men of God spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost." So that was a lot to go over, but wanted to give a clear example and show that the Holman gives a clear example of each example of the different color-coded themes of Scripture and how basically those are going to be categorized throughout the Rainbow Study Bible. So getting over to the actual scripture portion is when it really starts to get pretty neat, and we start to see just how much better and how improved this Holman Rainbow Study Bible really is. And we're going to see that it certainly is going to be the best and the latest and greatest Rainbow Study Bible. So we have the introduction here. We're going to have a book introduction. Obviously, that's with a lot of our study Bibles. Well, the Rainbow is no different. You get your author information, that Genesis was Moses, and estimates on when it was written, the time span that it covered. There's some of the background and where it was written, to whom it was written, and some of the content. And then we get a scriptural outline and some of the key words and themes. That's not necessarily new, but one of my favorite features of this new Holman Study Bible is that instead of having to have the bookmark, you get down here to the bottom of the page, and now you see these color-coded tabs. You're going to see those at the bottom of every single page of Scripture in the Holman Rainbow Study Bible. So you know, what we hear a lot actually from the old Rainbow Study Bibles is customers, they lose the bookmark. It's easy to do. You can misplace it, or you're having to keep it with you. You're constantly keep up when you're turning pages. Well, you don't have to do that anymore with this new one. Here it is, right at the bottom of the page. There you've got the full color-coded theme and all the tabs: discipleship, outreach, God, salvation, love, commandments, family, faith, prophecy, evil, sin, and history, and all right there on the page. So here is Genesis chapter 1, and here you're going to see, once again, certainly the old Rainbow Bibles did not have this, these full color maps. So we're seeing a subheading there, God's 6 days of creation, and we're seeing that, as promised, every single verse of the Bible is color coded. So in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. That is in the light gray. The light gray is going to be the history. So history, there is that kind of a lighter gray, if you will. And then in verse, almost to verse 3, the last half of Genesis 1-2, in purple, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. Then we see Genesis 1-3, and God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And you're going to see that "let there be light" is underlined. So the purple of "and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters," well, if we look down at the bottom there, we see that the purple is, well, appropriately named God. So we know, we see that purple, we know that verse is talking about God, and certainly it is, with the Spirit of God moving upon the face of the waters. Now the other interesting feature of the rainbow that mentioned in the preface and the introduction was the bold line system. And that bold line system is, once again, that's telling us where God, the Holy Spirit, and Christ are speaking. So let there be light. Well, we know that that's being spoken by God. So rather than where you will often see in other study Bibles, red letter edition or red letter text, as you see, often see the words of Christ in red, or something like a sword Bible where you have the words of God in red in the Old Testament as well as the words of Christ in red in the New Testament. Well, in the Rainbow Study Bible, you get the underlining. So you do know that that is deity, and that is deity speaking, "Let there be light." And we certainly see that again here in Genesis 1:9. "Let the waters under the heaven be gathered together unto one place, and let the dry land appear." And then, "and it was so." So the underlining ends. God is done speaking. And that's certainly a unique feature of the Rainbow Bible. So even though you're having the color coding, you still can tell when God is speaking, when Christ is speaking, when the Holy Spirit is speaking or moving or acting. And then we get to this in-text map and illustration, which certainly are very important features of the Rainbow Study Bible as well. Additionally, within the Holman Rainbow Study Bible, we're going to see these center column cross references that are familiar with, that's certainly a familiar format with many Bibles and many reference Bibles, and is an important study feature. So here within Genesis 1:1, "In the beginning God created the heaven and the earth," well, we see that A, which is next to the word beginning, and we know that if we go to the center column, that there is that reference of 1:1, and there is that A, and it tells us to go to John 1:1-2. And so we're going to do that, flip over to John 1:1, very familiar passage of Scripture and one of our favorite verses here at the KJV store. And here we go. So here's the book of John, John 1:1. Jesus is God's Word made flesh, and we see that "in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God." And verse 2, "the same was in the beginning with God." And we see here that that is an A next to "was the Word." Well, once again, if we know we're in John 1:1, well, here's several examples. John 1:2, 1:1, 1:2, 1:3. Well, John 1:1, it tells us, go to Proverbs 8:22-23, etc. And then Colossians 1:14, 1 John 1:1, Revelation 1:2, and 19:13. And so specifically that next one was Proverbs 8:22-23. So if we flip back to Proverbs, have that marked here. Here's Proverbs. So we've still got all of our color coding. We've still got our color coded guide and tabs at the bottom of the page, which are extremely handy and a really great new feature of the Rainbow Study Bible. And it's specifically said to go to Proverbs 8:22. Well, here's verse 22. The Lord possessed me in the beginning of his way before his works of old. In verse 23, I was set up from everlasting, from the beginning, wherever the earth was. So we're starting to see that theme of beginning. Genesis 1:1, in the beginning God created the heaven and earth. John 1:1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And now we see that in the beginning the Lord possessed me, in the beginning of his way before his works of old, and that I was set up from everlasting, from the beginning, wherever the earth was. And we continue on with that. Once again, that's Proverbs 8:22, and there is the 8:22 in the center column. It also says you can go to chapter 3:19. That means from the same book that we're in, which is Proverbs, then a semicolon, and John 1:1, kind of saying, did you come from John 1:1? Yes, we did. It's kind of in that same theme, but let's look at Proverbs 3:19 and kind of wrap up this cross-reference example from there. So Proverbs 3:19, there is Proverbs chapter 3, and specifically verse 19. We see that's in purple. We know that's talking about God. God. 3:19, the Lord by wisdom hath founded the earth, by understanding hath he established the heavens. By his knowledge the depths are broken up, and the clouds drop down the dew. And so that's the example there of the center column references. So we're learning that the Rainbow Study Bible, it's not just pretty. It is pretty. It's beautiful. It's unique. There's no other color-coded Bible in the world or in the history of Bibles to our knowledge. But it's extremely useful. It's beautiful and it's useful with the center column references, with the bold line underlining, and many useful features here. And just looking at this page, as you see all the different examples of the color coding, the pink there, so we know that's talking about outreach, the orange, which is going to be the discipleship, the yellow, which is going to be about family, my son, the gray, which is going to talk about sin, and my son, if sinners entice thee, consent thou not, more pink, so more talking about outreach. And of course, we've got more orange there, several different colors. This one is talking about faith. And there's the blue, which is specifically talking about salvation. We know salvation. So blue in verse 33, but whoso hearkeneth unto me shall dwell safely and shall be quiet from fear of evil. And really, this is a great page example showing all the different color-coded themes and really kind of organizing the Bible and helping you to understand it in within the realm of those 12 themes. So last but not least, we know about the color coding system, but probably my favorite thing, and probably what I consider one of the best new features of this Rainbow Study Bible, are going to be these really stunning full color maps and illustrations found throughout the Holman Rainbow Study Bible. And specifically, I want to get over here to John chapter 12 to start showing some of my favorite examples of the maps and the full color listing. So I have that marked here. I mean, here's John 11:56. There's an entire full color map there. And what I really like is this special section here on the New Testament Jerusalem in the time of Jesus on page 1059 there with John 12:27 ending at the top there. And so we don't just get maps in the back of the Bible, but you're actually getting a full color map right here in the Bible. So when you're reading about Jesus raising Lazarus from the dead, well, here is this map that helps you actually get a point of reference for where that happened and what was going on during that time. And it says here that Jesus had been preaching in the villages beyond the Jordan, probably in Perea, when he received the news of Lazarus' sickness. Jesus did not leave immediately, but waited 2 days before returning to Judea. He knew Lazarus would be dead when he arrived in Bethany, but he was going to do a great miracle. And so specifically, this is Perea, which is over there to the right. There's our Mediterranean Sea. And it specifically said that he had to make the journey to Bethany, so down here to Bethany. And now specifically, this New Testament Jerusalem in the times of Jesus, we're seeing here where that mentions that this is CA AD 30. The view is looking westward from a vantage point above the Mount of Olives. And you have this numbered key there. So there's number one, and it specifically said that is the road to Bethlehem and Hebron. And then there's an aqueduct, and that is number two. And the number three, the gate of the Essenes. There's number 3, and this is really neat. And then over here specifically, I like number 18. You kind of see this section down there. It looks like a wooded section. Well, we see that 18 is the Garden of Gethsemane, that 19 is the Mount of Olives. Well, it kind of gives you, there's the 19, and specifically it said, well, if you're from a vantage point above the Mount of Olives, that's where you'd be looking, and you have that reference. Well, that's right here, and didn't have to flip to the back of the Rainbow Bible. It's right here in John 12. I still got all my color-coded scripture. I still got my subheadings about Jesus' triumphal entry, about Mary anointing the feet of Jesus. But here we have this full-color illustration, and it's really just a really cool way to study the Bible and get a lot of additional information and make the Bible come to life even more and kind of put it in perspective of more modern terms and showing us the importance of the Bible and that history there. And next example would be Acts. So here we are in Acts chapter 1. I mean, really beautiful, full color, just bright colors. And specifically, this is a section on the key places in Acts. And I really like how I like this feature especially, where I'm going to read here. It says, the Apostle Paul, whose missionary journeys fill much of this book, traveled tremendous distances as he tirelessly spread the gospel across much of the Roman Empire. His combined trips by land and ship equal more than 13,000 airline miles. Well, yeah, that's a good way to put it in perspective. As someone who appreciates travel and enjoys traveling, it's pretty cool to put it in the perspective there. 13,000 airline miles, and specifically giving all the different points of Paul's missionary journeys. And I really like that section there. Another excellent one as we go over to here to Acts chapter 19 and verse number 23. So here we are zoomed out. We're seeing several things here. First of all, this is called the Temple of Artemis. There's that full color picture, not a painting, but an actual photograph of the Temple of Artemis. And of course, we have our color coded scripture. And at the bottom here, this is Caesarea Maritima, and it's actually kind of showing the port there and the reconstruction of that. But specifically, we're going to focus on this Temple of Artemis. And if we go to Acts chapter 19, verse 23, there's a subheading for us here, and it says, Demetrius the silversmith causes an uproar at Ephesus. And I'm going to read some of this here. And the same time there arose no small stir about that way, for a certain man named Demetrius, a silversmith, which made silver shrines for Diana, brought no small gain unto the craftsmen. Means he made them a lot of money. 25, whom he called together with the workmen of like occupation, and said, Sirs, ye know that by this craft we have our wealth. Moreover, ye see and hear that not alone at Ephesus, but almost throughout all Asia, this Paul hath persuaded and turned away much people, saying that they be no gods which are made with hands. So that only this our craft is in danger to be set at naught, but also that the temple of the great goddess Diana should be despised, and her magnificence should be destroyed, whom all Asia and the world worshipeth. And 28, and when they heard these sayings, they were full of wrath, and cried out, saying, Great is Diana of the Ephesians. And the whole city was filled with confusion, and having caught Gaius and Aristarchus, men of Macedonia, Paul's companions in travel, they rushed with one accord into the theater. The theater is the Temple of Artemis that we're seeing here. And last but not least, verses 30 and 31, and when Paul would have entered in unto the people, the disciples suffered him not, or allowed him not. And certain of the chief of Asia, which were his friends, sent unto him, desiring him that he would not adventure himself into the theater. Now notice that, this is interesting, that verses 23 through 29 kind of appear in that darker brown color, brown-looking color, which of course we know is dealing with evil. Evil, talking about the false gods. And appropriately enough, verses 30 and 31, I like that those actually appear in green. Well, we know that the green is dealing with love. Well, why would that be a verse on love? Well, because Paul's friends and the disciples there, they didn't want Paul to be harmed. They didn't want him to go into the Temple of Artemis. They wanted to protect him and keep him safe from that. The note on the Temple of Artemis, we're going to read here. In the city of Ephesus in ancient Asia Minor, we see that that is actually modern Turkey, so it gives us that modern take on where that is today and as far as geography today, and that construction on this temple was begun in 360 BC. And we see here that the cult was adopted by the conquering Alexander the Great of Greece and renamed Artemis or Roman Diana, and that the temple was completed by the Greeks and was recorded as one of the seven wonders of the ancient world, four times larger than the Parthenon at Athens. And certainly seems like an amazing structure. It would be a cool place to visit. And you know essentially that you could do that, that it basically Asia Minor, it's now in modern Turkey. And really cool how the scripture works together, and that story there about Demetrius, the silversmith, and that basically we have some historical perspective that he was one of the blacksmiths that very well was profiting from some of these temples and making these statues and different things for the false gods and idols and Greek gods. And moving on here in the rainbow, one other full-color map or illustration, one that I really appreciated here, is going to be in Revelation. We're here in Revelation chapter 1, and quickly we see here that the author is the Apostle John, that the date written was between AD 90 and 96, that this book is so named because it is the revelation of Jesus Christ as given to the Apostle John. It is also called the Apocalypse, which means unveiling. And I like this part about the background. John is exiled by the Roman government to Patmos, a small island off the coast of Greece, for preaching the word of God. His exile is only part of an intense period of persecution against the church, which follows the Roman Emperor Domitian's proclamation that he should be worshipped as deity. While on Patmos, John receives this revelation about Jesus Christ from God the Father. An angel helps John to understand the vision, whereas the first book of the Bible, Genesis, tells of the beginning of sin and Satan's triumph, the last book of the Bible, Revelation, tells of sin's end and Satan's defeat. A special blessing is promised to all who read, hear, and obey this book, but also a special curse is promised to those who add to or take away from these words. John also wrote the fourth gospel and the three letters that bear his name. So the Gospel John, 1st, 2nd, and 3rd John letters, and then Revelation. So over here we're seeing that basically with this note here, we can kind of see there is Patmos. And as it said in the background, that Patmos is where he was, and that is an island that is west of Greece. Well, here is Greece, and we see the full color illustration there, and the seven churches. The seven churches were located on a major Roman road. A letter carrier would leave the island of Patmos, where John was exiled, arriving first at Ephesus. He would travel north to Smyrna and Pergamos, turn east to Thyatira, and continue on to Sardis, Philadelphia, and Laodicea in the exact order in which the letters were dictated. So, once again, Patmos, there's that small island with a little blurb there about John writing Revelation, encouraging Christians to remain faithful. And again, it said a letter carrier, what would they do? They would go to Ephesus first, so from Patmos to Ephesus, there we go, then north along the road to Smyrna and Pergamos, and then basically going east to Thyatira. There's Thyatira to the east, and then continue on to Sardis, Philadelphia, and Laodicea. And that just kind of rounds out some of the list of the features there, some of the really good example of the full color illustrations. And past Revelation, when we get to the back of the Rainbow Study Bible, we see all these additional supplemental study aids. Basically, here's some of those extra features. Knowing what God says is one section there. Who is God? Well, that was your question, and you were going to give this as a gift to someone, say less familiar with the Bible, well, they can know to go and read all the purple verses about God. There it is, great is the Lord and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. Does God really love me? It says read all the green verses about love. Neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, with the reference Romans 8, 38, and 39. How do I get to heaven? It says to read the blue verses about salvation. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved, Romans 10, 13. Where do I get more faith? Well, read the orange verses about faith. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Romans 10:17. What are Satan's tactics? Read all the brown verses about evil. Why is my marriage important? Well, read all the yellow verses about the family. Therefore shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall become one flesh. Genesis 2:24. When should I tell others, or tell others about Christ? It says, read all the pink verses about outreach. Be ready always to give an answer to every man that asketh you a reason of the hope that is in you. 1 Peter 3:15. And special notes down here. Know what God also says about discipleship, sin, commandments, history, and prophecy in the KJV Holman Rainbow Study Bible. The first star says it takes less than 6 minutes to read all the blue verses on salvation in the Gospel of John, an ideal way to evangelize. And the second star says that it takes 10 minutes to read all the orange verses on faith in the Gospel of John, an ideal way to build faith. Really neat section there. Here is a section on 365 popular Bible quotations for memorization and meditation. And you basically got some from selections from every book of the Old and New Testament, and it's still color-coded. So you're going there, and you could actually just do this. You could have a single verse a day. So say if you wanted to just read a single verse a day, well, here's a selection for you. So on January 1st, you can know that God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him, male and female, created he them, Genesis 1:27, and it's kind of a little reading guide, and conveniently, you're still getting the color-coded theme and tabs down at the bottom, so you know exactly what all those different colors are referring to. So that's a nice feature that you're getting here. Once again, makes this Bible ideal for someone who's beginning. It's an excellent gift, good, perfect for gift giving, and just for even more experienced readers of the Bible to keep themselves organized. So here's a one-year Bible reading calendar, daily reading calendar. So if you wanted to complete the Bible in 1 year, basically, this actually is going to be a chart for going once through the Old Testament and twice through the New Testament in a year. So it tells me on January 1, okay, read Genesis 1 through 2 and Matthew 1. On January 2nd, read Genesis 3 through 5 and Matthew chapter 2. And that continues on, and basically I get that all the way through here through December. And I know that on December 25th, you get to read Revelation 4 through 5, and another good reading calendar there. There's a personal daily Bible reading calendar. We get a small section on words which have changed in meaning. So some of the archaic or obsolete words of the King James Version, you're going to get a alternate word or definition of that word. So we see that abased, it says that abased is actually going to be referring to humbled is another word for that. Accursed would be devoted. And those are some of those words that have changed in meaning. We also get a pretty large concordance here at the back of the Rainbow Study Bible. And basically, it's going to be pretty extensive there. It helps you find where certain words in the Bible are listed. Or if you wanted to specifically look up something like the word faith, we'd go to the F's here for faith. And we could find examples in the Bible about the word faith and where to find faith in the Bible. And certainly do that there. There's faith. O ye of little faith, with the reference there in Matthew 6:30. And after the concordance, we also have some special, it's a section for personal study notes. This is nice because it's some lined pages for notes. That's a pretty rare feature, pretty nice. It gives you several pages, about 10 pages or so of the lined pages for the notes. And then it rounds out with more full color maps at the back of the Rainbow Study Bible. Really more colorful than the average study Bible, the maps in an average study Bible, and special notes here and other illustrations like the ministry around the Sea of Galilee. That's a really neat picture there. And here is the Passion Week in Jerusalem, and it's kind of a diagram outlining Jerusalem. But there you have it. This is the Holman Rainbow Study Bible. It is the new KJV Rainbow Study Bible and the brown Montova leather touch, and really beautiful Bible. Don't forget that we can, of course, do the name imprinting. We can imprint your name on the Bible right there. We do it in gold to match the page edges. We hope that you enjoyed this review, and we look forward to sending you one soon.